President Joe Biden signed the $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan into law on Thursday afternoon, which represents his first major legislative victory for his administration, and the stimulus package paves the way for hundreds of billions of dollars in federal spending. The package includes more stimulus checks and unemployment benefits to combat the ongoing virus pandemic and its economic turmoil. Now, poll after poll shows that the stimulus package was overwhelmingly popular among American voters of both parties, and not a single Republican lawmaker voted to approve it, stating that it's not needed and the economy was on track to recover without additional stimulus. So Republican Minority Leader Mitch McConnell stated Democrats inherited a turning tide. The vaccine trends and economic trends were in place before this bill was ever voted on, before the president was sworn in, but they're determined to push to the front of the parade with this effort to push America to the left. McConnell went on to state that many in the GOP believe this rescue deal is unnecessary given the pace of our economic recovery. Regardless of your viewpoint of the bill, it is now law. So here are some of the major elements that are included in the package. So the package's biggest provision includes $1,400 direct payments for taxpayers earning less than $75,000 per year or $150,000 for a married couple. It's estimated that 85% of Americans will be eligible for the $1,400 stimulus check. This package also extends federal unemployment benefits of $300 per week through September of this year. It's $170 billion for K-12 education, which goes to reopening schools, $100 billion to expand vaccine distribution, and an expanded child tax credit that could provide up to $3,600 per child in financial support. I mean, this is a huge package. A family of four with a combined income of under $150,000 and one parent who's unemployed could see well over $10,000 in cumulative benefits over the year. There's also additional funding to help small business owners, $7.25 billion in additional funding for the Paycheck Protection Program. Now, the PPP is a relief fund that provides forgivable loans to struggling small businesses. In this newest package, President Biden erased restrictions for the Paycheck Protection Program, which expands its eligibility to include business owners with defaulted or delinquent federal student loans. The package does not include any student debt cancellation, as some have been pushing for. President Biden has said repeatedly that this needs to be put in a separate bill and approved by Congress. The package does make forgiveness of student loan debt tax-free. I mean, that is a huge benefit. So the latest stimulus package has a provision that exempts all student loan forgiveness from taxation through January 1st of 2026. The exemption is broad, covering government health, federal student loans, federally guaranteed FFEL program student loans, and private student loans. Now, the great thing that I want to point out, guys, is that most of the benefits in the stimulus package will not be considered taxable income, which means they should not significantly impact your monthly student loan repayments or anyone who's repaying student loans under an income-driven repayment plan. Now, the direct stimulus checks and child tax credits will not be considered taxable income, so that's great. They're not going to be taxed. Unemployment benefits typically are taxable, but a compromise in the bill exempts federal income taxes for up to $10,200 in unemployment benefits received this year. The stimulus bill also has subsidies for the Affordable Care Act, which aims to make health insurance, sometimes known as Obamacare, more affordable. Another interesting fact is there is $5 billion earmarked for black farmers who have lost land due to discrimination. So according to the Associated Press, in addition to some of the challenges faced by other farmers, black farmers have had to deal with less access to credit and technical support, which makes it harder for them to update equipment, purchase seeds, operate their farms, and buy more land. So statistics show there were more than 1 million black farmers at the turn of the century, but today there are less than 50,000 black farmers. So agricultural experts and advocates say that the loss is a combination of systemic racism, biased government policy, and social and business practices that have denied African Americans equitable access to markets. All right, child.Those, so according to the latest updates, some eligible Americans can expect to start receiving direct deposit payments over this weekend and into next week. Others will receive checks or debit cards in the mail over the next coming weeks. Comment below and let me know what you think about our latest stimulus package. If you found value in the video, do me a favor and hit that like button and share it with others on social media. It really helps to support and grow the channel. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell as I'm posting valuable new content multiple times a week. Thanks again for watching, and until next time.